Welcome to a lesson on the monotonicity criterion using instant runoff voting. In this lesson, we'll define the monotonicity criterion and also review an election result using instant runoff that violates the monotonicity criterion. The monotonicity criterion is a fairness criterion that states if voters change their votes to increase the preference for a candidate, it should not harm that candidate's chance of winning. And this can be an issue when using the voting method of instant runoff, which we just studied. Let's take a look at an example and begin by determining the winner of this election using instant runoff voting. First, notice if we sum this row here, we know there are a total of 200 votes, where candidate A has 74 first choice votes. Candidate B has 48 plus 24, or 72 first choice votes, and candidate C has 54 first choice votes. So using instant runoff voting, we would eliminate candidate C with 54 first place votes. So if we eliminate candidate C, or delete C from the table, notice how these 54 votes are now assigned to candidate A. So candidate A now has 74 plus 54, or 128 votes, and candidate B still has 48 plus 24, or 72 votes. And now because candidate A has a majority of the votes, or 64%, candidate A is the winner. But now let's consider that something happens and there needs to be a new election. Due to exit polling information, let's say 19 people who voted in the order of BAC change their vote to ABC. So again, 19 of these votes here switch their vote to this column of ABC, which means 19 people change their first choice from B to A and their second choice from A to B. So we would think that since 19 people change their vote from B to A, this should not prevent A from winning the election. So let's use this new table and use instant runoff voting. Notice in this case, candidate B has a total of 48 plus 5, or 53 first place votes, and candidate C has 54. So using instant runoff voting, we would eliminate candidate B from the election. So if we eliminate candidate B, or delete B from the table, so notice how this caused these 48 votes to be assigned to C, and these 5 votes to be assigned to A. So candidate A now has 93 plus 5, or 98 votes, candidate B has 0, and candidate C now has 48 plus 54, or 102 votes. So notice how now candidate C actually has a majority at 51% of the votes. So in this case, the monotonicity criterion has been violated since more voters switched to candidate A, but this caused A to lose the election. This does not mean that every time we apply instant runoff voting, the monotonicity criterion is violated, but this is something that we'd have to watch out for if we're using this method to select a winner. I hope you found this helpful.